Hello everyone, Kay with Zuna. Let's discuss price profile. And for those of you who are not familiar with price profile, it's pretty much the same thing as MP. And for those of you that are not familiar with MP nor price profile, you could do a little research on Google, but I'll give you just a summary. It's a methodology of analyzing the markets. You can refer to it as an indicator, but it's more of a tool than an indicator, or several indicators. It's a multi-layered indicator, meaning several indicators in one tool that you can use to analyze the market. It's a very valid approach, and I highly recommend it if you're not using it, to at least give it a shot and see if it resonates with you. With TradeStation, I've tried several different profile indicators, and most of them I didn't like, primarily because they were not accurate in terms of, first, they don't show the profile with the text. Second, a lot of them, the value areas or the POC is just not accurate. This profile here, I've checked with other vendors that do provide price profile as a service or a subscription, which is usually between $100 to $500 a month, depending on which you go with. That's a monthly fee. And there are other sources where you can pretty much create one on Excel and check the data for it yourself if you know how to figure value. So my point being that I finally had to create one myself, and this is accurate. So when you are looking at the value area or the point of control, it's accurate. That's very important. So let's go ahead and take a look at some of these charts. I have ES, and I'm on the East Coast, so the times would be Eastern Standard Time. This is just the pit session profile, which is 9:30 to 16:15. Market opens 9:30 to 16:15, and of course I have this on a 30-minute bars, but I don't trade off of a 30-minute bar if I'm intraday trading. So you don't have to have it on a 1-minute chart, for those of you that aren't familiar with profile, to trade off of a 1-minute or 5-minute chart. You can have it on it's suggested to use on a 30-minute chart, and I've tried it on many different intervals, and I do prefer it on a 30-minute chart. So this is your pit session profile. When you want to look at the entire day's profile, when I say entire days, I mean the regular session on TradeStation would be, if you just put it on regular session, your chart would be between 16:30 to 16:15 for ES, and that's New York time again. So as you can see, we have a full profile of the entire day. You have the value area, point of control, the initial balance is to the left of it. And here, what I've done is, and this is something you guys could do if you haven't tried it and see if you like it, but on the right here, I have pit session, as we saw the first chart we looked at, 9:30 to 16:15, which is basically when the pits open, and the initial balance being this magenta line here is very important for the pit session, extremely important. And a lot of people don't pay attention to it, but it is a very important part of price profiling. And then what I've done on this side, I have the overnight session profiled as well. So I've taken here, we looked at the prior chart, we looked at the entire overnight, including the regular session or the pit session starting at 9:30, so it started. This bar closed at 9:30, so we opened up here and markets just dropped. What I've done on the next chart that we'll look at, I've created a profile for this area. This is when the cash index is open, and a profile for this area. So essentially, we have one profile for here and another one here, and that's what we'll look at right now. So that's the overnight area. I should say the overnight profile, and this is the pit session profile for ES. Now, if you trade, I'm going over examples on ES because everybody's familiar with ES, but you can certainly do this on any market. You can do it on any market that you trade. If you trade currency futures, you can do it on that. You can do it on, if you're trading if you're trading Forex, you can do that. Whatever your instrument of preference is, you can do the same thing. You can profile, you can create your own custom sessions with TradeStation. It's very simple. You go to Format Symbol, then you go to Properties tab. Next to Session, you'll see this button here, View Customize. And use your regular session or use your custom session. If you want to create custom sessions, you click Create, and then you can create the time, any time period that you want. Now, once you create that, then you can profile that chart with this indicator. So here I have Forex, the entire one-day session profiled. Then I have New York time profiled, and I have Tokyo time profiled. So if I just finished day trading, let's say the index futures, and I take a break, and New York time finishes at 5 on my, or on where I am. So I want to trade a little bit of trading in the evening Tokyo time. I want to see what happened in the New York. I want to see the profile shape. I want to see the value area for New York. I also want to see the 24-hour period so I can be prepared for the Tokyo time. So I've profiled all of these three different. Now, a lot of Forex traders, what they do is they'll profile the Tokyo, the New York, and then they'll also do the London and the Sydney. And this is basically on stocks. I have it profiled on stocks. This is a $66 stock. It's XOM, ExxonMobil. And let's say you want to trade, a high price stock. Go to inputs, and here, minimum tick, change that to 5. Okay. And then let's go to high price stock. Okay, it's a $300 stock. The minimum tick is 1 penny, so that would be 317 times 1 penny. You can imagine what the minimum ticks and how much work this would do and how much PC resource it would use. So that's why we changed that minimum tick to 5. You would do the same thing with Forex, as Forex has 5 decimal points usually, and I have it set to 5 here. As you can see, we have TPO session start time and TPO session end time. So whatever custom sessions you create with TradeStation, then you would just have to reinsert those session times into here, and that's all you need to do, and then just click OK. So I have it 8 to 1700 for New York, and let me show you Tokyo. I have it 19 to 4 a.m. So whatever custom sessions you create with TradeStation and you want to insert the profile indicator into it, that chart, then what you would do is also apply the session time that you've created to. Now, keep in mind, apply the session time of what's showing on your chart. My chart shows 8:30 to 1700. Now, TradeStation plots the time on the close of the bar. That's why I have it at 8, because the close was at 8:30, and 1700 is the close for the end of that session. Okay, so that's pretty much profile indicator. Very solid indicator, very accurate indicator. I prefer to have a separate chart. Okay, and this is a small monitor that I'm doing this video on, but I'd like to have it on a larger chart. As you can see, you have your value area, this white line, the vertical line, that's your value area. And this is your initial balance. Below you have your value low, value high, and point of control. Very good. Thanks for watching. If you have any questions, contact us.